This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to talk about graphing exponential functions. And specifically, I'm going to deal with functions where the base is a number greater than 1. I'll do a separate video where the base is a fraction between 0 and 1. Okay, so the basic function I want to use as an example is y equals 2 to the x. Now, whenever the base is a number greater than 1, you're going to have an increasing function. It's going to curve upwards from left to right, like that. We can figure out the domain of this by asking ourselves, what values could x have? Well, since I can raise 2 to any power whatsoever, I can raise it to a negative number, a 0, or a positive number, that means x can be any value at all, so the domain is going to be all real numbers, or negative infinity to infinity. What about the range? Well, no matter what number I use for x, I can never make this 2 to the x equal 0 or anything negative. It can get very small, but it will never be 0 or negative. So the range is going to be from 0 up to positive infinity. Okay, it can get very small, so that's going to tell us about the asymptote. As x gets more and more negative, as the graph moves further and further over to the left, we're going to have a smaller and smaller value for 2 to the x. So the asymptote is going to be at y equals 0. And we can find the y-intercept by just asking ourselves, what happens when x equals 0? Since the y-intercept happens along the y-axis, and that's where x equals 0. So 2 to the 0, or actually any base number to the 0, is going to equal 1. So we're going to have a y-intercept at 0, 1. Okay, let's take that information and see what we can do as far as sketching in a rough graph. I know this is going to increase. I know I'm going to have an asymptote along the x-axis. I'm going to have a point at 0, 1. And if I had one more point, it would be easy to sketch the graph in. Well, let's ask ourselves what happens when x equals 1. When x equals 1, y is going to equal 2, since 2 to the first power is just 2. So we're going to have another point at 1, 2. Now, in general, you're going to have a point for these basic exponential functions at 1, and then whatever the base is. Because when we raise a base to the first power, we're just going to get the value of that base. Okay, but in this case, we've got 1, 2. We know where the horizontal asymptote is, so I can just roughly draw in a curve, and I'll have a rough graph for this function, y equals 2 to the x. Okay, now let's look at some transformations. So here I've got a little better graph with coordinates and everything. Let's take that y equals 2 to the x and turn it into y equals 2 to the x plus 3. Actually, let's make that a minus 3. Okay, so what I'm going to do here is take the original 2 to the x and just drop it down by 3 units. So I'm going to have a horizontal asymptote at y equals negative 3, and then all the points on the graph will drop downward 3 units. I'll find out where some of those points are and just sketch in the graph. So if I add a negative number after the exponential expression, I'm going to drop the graph downward. If I added a positive number, like plus 4, it would raise the graph up by that many units. Okay, so that's a vertical shift. What about vertical stretches? What if I have y equals 3 times 2 to the x? Okay, well, what this is going to do is take my original y values and multiply them by 3. It's going to stretch the graph upward. So instead of having 0, 1, I would have 0, 3. Instead of having 1, 2, I would multiply the 2 by 3 and get 1 comma 6. I'm going to have the same horizontal asymptote, so I can sketch this graph in as well. If I had made that a negative 3, it would have not only stretched the graph, but it would have flipped it across the x-axis. So it would have gone downward. Let me find some points. It would have gone downward something like this. Okay, so a coefficient in front of the exponential expression is going to stretch the graph vertically. If it's a positive coefficient, it'll just stretch it vertically without flipping it. If it's a negative coefficient, it will flip it and stretch it. Okay, so those are the vertical transformations. We can stretch it, we can flip it, and we can shift it. We can do horizontal transformations as well. I can take that 2 to the x, and let's make it 2 to the x plus 3. What this plus 3 is going to do is shift the graph 3 units to the left. This is similar to other transformations you've seen. If we add a positive number after the x, it shifts the graph that many units to the left. If we add a negative number to the x, it shifts the graph that many units to the right. So in this case, I'm shifting the graph to the left by 3 units. I'll have a point at negative 3, 1. I'll have another point at negative 2, 2. Like I said, I have a point here at negative 1, 4. The horizontal asymptote is unchanged, so the graph will shift over like that. If I change the sign of the exponent, if I make this a 2 to the negative x, what that's going to do is flip the graph across the y-axis. So it's going to reflect it horizontally, and it looks something like this. Okay? So those are the horizontal transformations we can make. Now, of course, we can combine some of these, and this is where it gets tricky. So I could have y equals 2 times 2 to the x minus 1 minus 3. Now let's first just understand what this is going to do. That x minus 1 is going to shift the graph over 1 unit horizontally to the right. The 2, the coefficient that I have here, is going to stretch the graph upward by a factor of 2. And then after I've done that, the negative 3 is going to drop the whole thing down 3 units. So it's still going to have the same upward curve, but it's going to be dropped down a bit, it's going to be stretched and moved over. Rather than do that all at once, or rather than try to figure that out just by looking at it, let's just do a quick table with some values. So let's see what happens when x is, let's make x into a 1. When x is 1, then I'm going to have 2 to the 0, 1 minus 1. So 2 to the 0 is just 1. When I multiply that by 2, I'm going to get 2. And then when I subtract 3 from it, I'll get a negative 1. And then let's see what happens when x is 2. Well, when x is 2, I'm going to have 2 to the 2 minus 1, or 2 to the first power, which is 2. I'll multiply that by 2. So 2 times 2 is 4. I want to subtract 3 from that. So that's going to give me 4 minus 3 is positive 1. So let's put those points in. I've got a 1 and a negative 1. So this is 1, negative 1. And I've got a 2, comma 1. That's over here. I know I dropped this thing down, so I should also put in where the horizontal asymptote's going to be. I dropped it down 3 units. So the horizontal asymptote is going to be at y equals negative 3. And now I can just take those two dots and imagine what the rest of the curve would look like. And I'm going to have something like this. Okay? So if you've got something fairly complex, what you might want to do is get a mental picture of what it's going to look like. maybe draw in your horizontal asymptote, and then actually take some values, make a table of values for x and y, plot those values, and then draw your graph. Okay, so that's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.